8 Money Habits That Are Stopping You From Getting Rich. What's up guys? Are you in for another awesome video? Let's talk about 8 Money Habits That Are Stopping You From Getting Rich. But before we spill the tea, kindly click that subscribe button and bell for more clever videos like this. So, here we go! Hit that like button first. Money habit number 1 is paying yourself last. Here's what I mean by this. As soon as you get paid, you pay your rent, your phone bill, your gym membership, you go out to dinner, you buy something nice for yourself, and you're planning to save if there's any money left at the end of the month. The problem is, there's never any money left to save. Sounds familiar? People who get ahead financially do the exact opposite. They pay themselves first, which means that before they start paying their bills, swiping their cards left and right, plus giving money to everyone else except for themselves, they put a portion of everything they make into their own pockets first. Then, they pay their bills and live on what's left. They prioritize making themselves richer versus making other people richer. People who are good at saving money understand its importance, called Parkinson's Law. Parkinson's Law is the principle that demands will always expand to consume all available resources, even if you have a week to finish. The project you end up taking and all that time to finish it, you were probably pretty inefficient with your time. Whereas if you have just 1 hour to finish that same project, you'll be super focused and efficient and still get it done. So, work expands to consume all available time. And it's the same with money you're spending. It will expand to consume all available money. Whether you have $100 or $100,000, your expenses will keep increasing to consume all the money that you have. That's why making more and more money isn't always the answer. And saving money after you do all of your spending is not gonna work because your spending will always rise. Just to eat up all that money, you got to pay yourself first. You gotta treat yourself by saving money like a bill, so as soon as you get paid to commit, set aside 10% of whatever percentage that you can handle and put that towards savings and investments, and then just live on. What's left is that if you want to stop letting money slip through your fingers and you want to start keeping some of what you make for yourself, then give up money habit number 1 for good. The next money habit to give up is trying to keep up with friends who have expensive taste. Do you have friends who always want to go out to expensive restaurants and go shopping with them and go on trips with them and stay in nice hotels? If you have friends with bigger budget than yours, then it's okay to be authentic and say, "Just so you know, I can't do that because I'm working towards some financial goals right now and I need to save money. It's out of my budget." If they are real friends, they'll understand everyone has very different levels of taste as well as different budgets. Trying to keep up with everyone around you is going to leave you broke and in debt. This includes friends as well as people you see on social media. The reality is, the average American has very little savings and an average of $38,000 in debt. And that's not even including mortgages. A lot of what you see in terms of amazing lifestyles on social media is often just an illusion. I know someone who is always posting Instagram photos of herself traveling to all kinds of exotic locations, and it looks like she has this glamorous, awesome life. But the reality is, she has $20,000 in credit card debt and has zero in savings and investments. So, don't be fooled. A lot of what you see is not real and chasing experiences. Just so you can post a cool photo on Instagram or look good to everybody else is a recipe for ending up broke. The third money habit, to give up, is putting everything on your credit card for the cashback, a reward. Don't get me wrong, credit cards are amazing. The money habit to give up is to make sure you only put things on your rewards credit card if you have the money. Pay for it in cash and don't justify the purchase just because of the points of miles. Money habit number 4. Having disorganized finances. Having disorganized finances is another way of keeping your head in the sand. If you have credit cards open everywhere, student loans that you don't know the balance for, and you're not sure what you're spending every month, then it's really time to consolidate. So there's a lot of really awesome apps out there that make it super easy to track all your financial stuff. For example, I used to use Mint and I liked it. You can connect your bank accounts and your credit cards. And they'll look at your spending and your income and tell you what your spending looks every month. And you can also put in all your accounts and look at your network, then how it changes over time. And it really only takes a few minutes to set up. It's worth your time. And ever since I've switched over to tracking my finances in a spreadsheet versus in apps, because I'm just a big nerd and I love spreadsheets, and I look at my spreadsheet to update my net worth every month. That way I can see the progress that I'm making month by month. And not only is this hugely motivating, but it also forces me to keep my finances very organized because I know where all my money is at all times. Something also helps with keeping your finances organized. It is choosing a financial institution that offers a wide range of services so that you can do all your financial stuff in one place. The less online usernames and passwords you have to keep track of, the better. For example, I have my checking account as well as most of my investment accounts. I have all that Fidelity so I could access all my financial stuff with one username and it was convenient. Another place that offers a full suite of services is Betterment, which offers a checking account, high-yield savings account, as well as different investments account for all your financial goals. Either way, with technology and all these amazing platforms, it's not hard to get and stay organized with your finances. The key is just get up that courage to look at where you stand financially. And I know it can be a humbling and sobering moment for some people, but until you know what is the starting point, it's impossible to get where you wanna be. You know how you can get to where you wanna be if you don't know where you are now. So give up the habit of staying confused about your finances to build a habit of staying organized and looking at your numbers regularly. Money habit number 5, numbing yourself to debts. We live in a society where practically everybody has debt. It has become normal for someone in their 20s to have tens of thousands of dollars of student loan debt. And it's normal for someone in their 40s to have a mortgage, car loan, credit card debt, and possibly even paying off their student loans still. But listen up, just because everyone else lives with debt, don't make it okay for you to live with debt. Don't get into debt if you don't have to just pay for things in cash. Don't do things if you can't afford it. Don't go into debt for college and months unless you have to. And you know you'll get a job that will allow you to pay that off quickly. Don't get a car loan to buy a car. Don't get a mortgage if you're still paying off student loans. It's just too much. America is one of the wealthiest countries in the world, yet somehow, it's considered okay to have crops load of debt. These days, the status quo is to live with debt. But don't settle for the status quo. Do whatever you need to do to live debt-free. Money habit number 6. Paying extra due to lack of planning. I used to be the king of cheap $10 umbrellas because I always forgot to check the weather and I just end up getting caught in the rain and having to run into a drugstore to just buy another umbrella. Despite having multiple umbrellas at home, not planning in advance and being caught unprepared always ends up costing you money. So this could be things like having to take an Uber instead of using your subway card. It could also be like paying overdraft fees because you didn't check your account balance. Another way is you put things on a credit card and you just end up paying all these interest charges. Because you didn't set money aside for unexpected expenses, no, I'm all about YOLO and living spontaneously, but if you're always having to buy things you already have at home or just paying extra fees and interest because you're unprepared, then just take a few extra minutes to plan, to check the weather before you leave the house, leave buffer time in between appointments, look at your account balance every so often, and things like that. Even just a little bit of planning will save you tons of money. And at the end of the day, having money in the bank is what allows you to YOLO as much as you want. Money habit number 7. Paying too much in taxes. Paying too much in tax is going to be the single biggest expense in your lifetime. So why not do it? You can cut down on your tax, bill most of the tax. Blue bills are for the rich people who own assets and businesses, but there are a lot of tax loopholes available to the average person as well. Money habit number 8. Putting off investing until you have more money. Like I mentioned in my first tip, putting things off like saving money and investing for the future is a very slippery slope. You might be thinking that you'll start doing it one day when you have more money. But more often than not, that becomes a never-ending cycle of procrastination and excuses. There's always going to be reasons why you can't invest enough money, not enough knowledge, not enough time, other priorities, and etc. But the longer you put off investing, the harder you'll have to work to get the same level of financial freedom as someone who starts investing earlier. Someone who starts investing at age 20 can become a millionaire by age 50 by investing just $180,000 of their own money. However, if they were to wait until age 30 to start investing, they would need to invest almost twice as much of their own money to reach millionaire status by age 50. Which means, the sooner you start, the less heavy lifting you have to do, and the less of your own money it takes to get to a millionaire. Even if it's just $50 a month, start investing now. Don't wait. It's easy to start investing if you just stick your money in some low-cost index funds. It's a form of self-care, and self-care is fun because it makes you feel good and makes your life so much better. If you've recognized yourself doing any of these money habits, just be gentle with yourself. You know, don't beat yourself up about it because most of us don't learn this stuff in school and we don't learn it from our parents. Most of us people who have good money habits usually just learn it the hard way, by screwing up and wanting to do better. Finance Boss is not perfect by any means. We're just willing to share our knowledge based on our own research and based on our personal experiences. Also, we have a lot of stuff that we need to learn too. But it's not all about having the awareness and the financial literacy to notice whether your daily actions bring you closer to your financial goals or take you further from your financial goals. And it's never too late to replace bad money habits with good money habits and to just improve your relationship with money. So, if you want to keep the ball rolling, make sure to check out our channel for more videos to inspire you to teach you more about money videos like this. Please like this video and subscribe to our awesome channel. Go Money Savers!